Today, she actually walked out of a House Democrats meeting before it was over, saying they aren't taking sexual harassment seriously.
She spoke very clearly about things that female Democratic members are doing, which I think are all great efforts. But let's talk about the big elephant in the room. And that's why I was done with the meeting. I don't have time for conversations that are not real. And I, for one, am not going to stand silent, even in the face of pressure from leadership not to.
And the Congresswoman joins me now from Capitol Hill. Thanks so much for being with us. So let's talk about the walking out. You said you walked out of the meeting today. They weren't taking it seriously. How so?
Well, this is probably the biggest issue that we're talking about here, not just in Washington, D.C., but across the country. And I felt that the morning that we returned back to Washington, it was a relevant issue to address. We had, it's a caucus meeting that we have in the morning where most of the members in the Democratic caucus come. And I thought that that was a perfect setting to have a real conversation about what we're going to do as a party to address this, what is now becoming an epidemic across the country. And I didn't feel that the conversation that we had was sufficient.
The chairman of the Congressional Black Caucus, Cedric Richmond, and Congressman James Clyburn were confronted in the halls of Congress today about Conyers, and I just want to play that exchange.
Other men in other industries have faced similar accusations and gotten out of the way, resigned, stepped down far faster than he has. Right?
No, you would have to give me some examples.
Harvey Weinstein, Charlie Rose, Matt Lauer.
I don't think they
who elected them?
Who elected them? Is that an appropriate response?
I don't think so. I actually think that the fact that we, all of us here as representatives and senators, are sent here because of the public trust. We put our name on a ballot. We ask the public to trust us to go and do their work for them in Washington, and we should honor that trust. I can't speak for the reaction of those, my two colleagues there, but it's that kind of response that leads everyday Americans to say, what is going on in Washington? Why is everyone in the private sector held accountable? And yet when the same kind of behavior is exposed in Washington, D.C., they circle the wagons and protect their own. And I, for one, am not going to be in that position.
Why do you think there is such a discrepancy between how sexual harassment claims are being dealt with right now in the corporate world, finally, and how they're being dealt with in the political sphere?
I think Washington, D.C. is probably the greatest example of the last old boys club. And everything in Washington, as the public well knows, is done in secret, pretty much. I mean, you come down here and you're in a bubble, and then you go home and you talk about what you do or what you're not getting done. But there's a reason why Congress has a 6% approval rating in this country. And I think it's due in large part to the fact that people see that we come down here, we're supposed to be getting things done, and we don't. And then when things happen like this, we don't respond the way we should respond. What about giving these women, hearing these women, and finding most of these allegations? I haven't heard one person prove that any of these allegations were not credible. And if you speak to some of these women, as I have in my career, they'll tell you that, look, I felt that there were, you know, I took the steps that I did because I was afraid of the professional consequences to me if I spoke out or I didn't settle a case. Where are the professional consequences for the abusers? We in Congress, right here, right now, at this seminal moment in this country's history, have the opportunity to say, we are going to lead on this issue, and we are not going to allow this kind of abusive environment to exist anymore. Mm.